We're still joined by Attorney Christian Monsod, one of the framers of the 1987 Constitution and a former Paul Body Commissioner. Hello again, Attorney Monsod. Sorry for the interruption. You were bringing up a point about political dynasties a while ago in our interview. You're saying you're seeing two options. One, of course, is leaving it to the electorate to decide never to vote again for political dynasties. Of course, that's a tall order. The other option would be the next leader to work on an anti-dynasty law. Now, do you really think, are you confident, are you even seeing it as realistic as a future leader or a president perhaps could push or make a push for anti-dynasty?
Well, I know that if the president I voted for becomes president, that she will pursue an anti-dynasty law. And I think the people should speak. Actually, there are some good signs. There were some good signs in 2019. Mm-hmm. There were some political who lost all their seats. And then there are good young people who are incorruptible, who were elected into several municipalities. Mm-hmm. The people are looking for change. And then, of course, you have the experience of the community pantries where those who have share what they have with those who need. I think it's there. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, to me, what happens during the pandemic shows that there can be transformation at the bottom level, regardless of who is in power. Mm-hmm. And that's a good sign. And I hope that this election will produce more good signs of the people themselves taking part and initiating and committing themselves to social change.
All right. The problem seems to be the fact that a lot of Filipinos are ambivalent when it comes to political dynasties, because really some political dynasties work.
Yeah, maybe, but I think the bottom line is they have to vote for an anti-dynasty law, even if there are some good people, good dynasties, because that's the root of our problem. And what happened? People talk about democracy and how to have to fight socialism or communism. I think the big fight in our country is the growing divide between the rich and the poor, the increasing inequality. It is really democracy versus an oligarchy. That's really the battle for the heart and soul of the Filipino nation. It's democracy versus oligarchy. And you cannot have democracy and oligarchy. Mm-hmm. If you look at the 89 French Revolution, they rebelled against the divine right of kings. And they installed a new principle, sovereignty in the people. So we have to ask ourselves, in our country, really 1% of the families who have the wealth and power, and ask ourselves, do we have the fiction of a democracy? Mm-hmm. As long as there is oligarchy.
Attorney Monsod, you mentioned that the divide between the rich and poor, of course, is growing. That's quite the propaganda for a lot of the presidentials during this elections, even in the previous ones. How do you correct that kind of mindset, that it doesn't turn into propaganda, but it turns into what you mentioned as democracy versus oligarchy? Attorney, are you with us?
Well, as I said, hello.
We can hear you, sir. Go ahead.
Hello. Are we okay?
Yes, sir. Please continue.
Yeah. I'm very impressed by the young people today. Mm-hmm. They're concerned. They want to inform themselves. And they take action, and they're much better than we were at their age. Maybe that's why we did not fulfill the promise because our only victory was restoring democracy, and there's still the question of do we have real democracy today. But I like what's happening with our young people in this country. It's time for us to let go and let them lead our country to its greatness. It's their future now, and we have to support the young people in among our midst who are doing all the right things.
When it comes to empowering the youth, they play such a crucial role. They could either be, as you mentioned, people who would push for change, but they are also sometimes the sources of disinformation or misinformation through social media. How important is it to choose, I guess, the kind of leader that will be able to inspire honesty, those kinds of right values instead of the other?
Well, I think our youth will do it. I think we have to support them. And they're the hope. It's their future. And I'm hopeful, although I know it's a difficult journey, I'm hopeful it will happen if we elect the right people today. And if we elect the right people at the barangay level in December 22, then I think we're on our way. And we have to have the commitment and the endurance of a long distance runner if we're going to have real change. But I think we have to trust the young people. Time for us to let go.
How about to protect them, attorney? They're also, of course, sometimes victims of disinformation and also a lot of trolls. How do we protect the youth?
Well, we have to live with it. I said we have a new communication framework, and the youth know it better than we do. Right, the young people know what this is all about, and I'm really watching these elections and how the youth will vote. Whether we win or lose, it's what the young people are going to do in these elections that will put us on the right path. So we know, and they know more about the situation on the new communication framework. It's not a secret.
Attorney Christian Monsod, thank you so much, attorney, for your time.